I'm Henrik, one of the founders and CEO of Perdoo. And in this video, I'm going to show to you how to build a good roadmap for your business. Now, the first thing that you should do, if you haven't done so already, is to click the start trial button in the top right corner of your screen in order to unlock all the premium features. Then the next thing that you should do is to go into configure, head over to the features tab, and then to enable flexible progress calculation. If that isn't enabled yet, simply click save and then head back to roadmap. I'll explain later why you need to enable that feature. Then you should collapse the left sidebar, which you can do by clicking on this button here in the bottom left corner. And that creates a lot more space on your screen right here. Now, roadmap always starts with the ultimate goal of your business, which is kind of like the mission and vision for your company. If you haven't added one through the onboarding steps, simply add one by click on add your ultimate goal. And then for Perdoo, it is to help ambitious organizations execute strategy and propel their growth. Now, the next thing that you should do is to set up your organization strategy, which you can do in the form of strategic pillars. Now, we can have a long video to explain what is a good strategy, but it will be better if you just head over to our resources hub, which you can access by going to perdoo.com/resources. And then if you search for strategy here, then you'll find all our strategy related articles. Now, this article here, looking to get aligned, put strategy first, OKR second. That's an article that I wrote in order to explain to you what is strategy, what is an ultimate goal, how do you define a good ultimate goal for your company, what are strategic pillars, and then how do you decide what are the right strategic pillars for your company. So this is an article that I definitely recommend you to read. And if you do need more help with that, we do have, of course, those in-house coaching services available, which you can buy at an additional cost. Now, to add our first strategic pillar, simply click on add strategic pillar. And then an important strategy for Perdoo is to offer the best resources and support along with in-house coaching. Now, we can also add a description to better explain to everyone in our organization why this is our strategy. So we can say that in our industry, it takes more than just a software to make our customers successful. Now, in fact, we have a longer rationale for this strategy, but for now, I'm just gonna hit save, and you can then see that we have our first strategic pillar created. If I move my mouse over the strategic pillar, then the description appears. Now, the next thing that you can do then is to align both KPIs as well as OKRs to such a strategic pillar. So to add a KPI, we can simply head over here and then click on create new KPI. And then the question is, of course, what are the things that we constantly need to invest in, that we constantly need to be monitoring in order to make sure that we continuously deliver the best resources and support? So I'm just going to create a new example KPI, but if we want to make sure that our support is absolutely the best in the industry, one thing that we could look at is the customer satisfaction score. So the customer satisfaction score is a survey that goes out after each support interaction with our team, asking you to rate the quality of the services that you received. So in this case, I'm going to say we want CSAT to be to be equal at or above 9. Now, this is a KPI typically for a customer support team. You see in the dropdown here that we don't have a customer support team created yet. So I'm just going to create it directly from here, type the name of the team that I want to create, and then click here on add new. And then it will automatically create this as a new team in Perdoo. Now, the lead for this objective should be the head of our customer support, which in this case would be Emilia. She probably doesn't exist as a user yet in the product, but you see that if I type her email right here, I can easily invite Emilia to Perdoo. So that's what I'll do. Now I'll hit save. And you can then see that in the bottom here, I can add different monthly targets for this KPI. Now, I already told you that I want this KPI to be at 9 or higher. So I'm going to add a 9 right here. And then it automatically populates the future targets as well. If I want to increase these targets in the future, I simply click on the month from which I want to increase it and then say, well, from July, we actually want to be a bit more ambitious and then increase it to 9.5. I'm going to click this away because the next thing that we're going to do is to add OKRs to the screen. The way we work with OKRs at Perdoo is we work with an annual and a quarterly combination. That is a combination that works for 97% of our customers, although you can completely customize that. If you want to work with 3-year objectives and then go down to annual and then to monthly objectives, that's also how you can set it up if you go here into the configure menu and then head over to the cadences tab. The way we work with OKRs at Perdoo is at the end of each year, our leadership team comes together and they then start thinking about the 3, 4, or maybe even 5 bigger themes that they want everyone to focus on throughout the next year, or in this case, 2022, taking into account, of course, our organization strategy, how was last year performance, what changed in the market, and all other factors. Now, to add an annual objective for this strategic pillar, I hover over the strategic pillar, click on the plus icon, select create new objective, and then I'm going to say that to have really the best resources and support along with in-house coaching, one thing that I want us all to focus on throughout this year is to have the best onboarding experience in our industry. Now, you can see that the owner is the company. This is an annual company objective. I will lead it for now. It is automatically aligned to the strategic pillar that we selected. So I'm going to hit save now and create this as a 2022 objective. Now, the next thing that we can do is also create a quarterly OKR. What we do at Perdoo is that we set the strategy, we set the annual company objectives, and then we ask the different teams to come up with their own suggestion of OKRs each quarter. And then we review those together to see if we're all on the same page about the things that they should be focusing on. But for this video, I'm going to complete the roadmap and add a quarterly OKR as well. I'm going to add a quarterly OKR to this 2022 objective. I'm hovering over it, click the plus icon, select create new objective. And now I'm going to say that in Q1, we want to successfully launch new video series to better support new users. Now, that is going to be an objective for our product marketing team, which also doesn't exist yet. So I'm just going to create that directly from here. The head of our product marketing team is Mark. So I'm going to invite him to Perdoo right away. And I'm going to put this objective in draft mode since we still need to review that all together. And for the purpose of this video, I'm just going to create it without adding any key results. So now you see that we have a quarterly OKR on the screen as well. If I click this button right here, then I see the bigger cards and I can then see the objective that we have set up. If you have a lot of objectives or goals on your screen, you can use the zoom in and zoom out functionality. And of course, you can always apply different filters to filter out that combination of goals that you want to be looking at that time. Now, the last thing that I wanted to show you is that for these annual company objectives, it doesn't always make sense to create key results. Sometimes you want to base their success on the progress of all the OKRs that are aligned to it. Now, to set that up, open the objective by clicking on this icon here in the top right corner. And then you can see that we have a results tab. We don't have any key results or initiatives created. We do have also an aligned objectives tab with one OKR already aligned to it. Now, if I wanna make sure that progress for this objective is based on the aligned objectives instead of the key results, you can see by this icon right here that progress is currently based on the key results. I need to edit the objective by clicking on this three-dot menu here in the top right corner. Select edit objective and then scroll all the way down to advanced options. And then here I can choose that progress shouldn't be based on key results, but should be based on the aligned objectives. And then once I hit save, I have now completed this setup. So this is how you can build a roadmap for your organizations. If you do have any questions, simply click on this chat icon here in the bottom right corner. That opens a support chat with our team, and then someone will get back to you ASAP.